my relationship to the Maine wilderness is my entire life. This is where I'm from. This is where I call home, and this is the environment and the ecosystem that has defined who I am. From work and play to developing my own personal conservation ethic and my own understanding of these relationships of people in outdoor spaces, it's all filtered through this place. It's really humbling and astounding that this is now one of the prime places where we have a shot at making a difference in perpetuating the Atlantic salmon as a species.
Maine is the last state in the United States that actually has wild Atlantic salmon. They can live in fresh water, migrate to the ocean, grow up to be a super-sized fish, and then migrate all the way back to nearly the exact spot, and that fish knows literally where it grew up.
So we're here in the Penobscot watershed. It starts right here on Whitecap Mountain along the Appalachian Trail. So this is the source for all that cold water that goes cascading down through huge natural features like Gulf Haggis. So the Henderson Brook Project is one of the highest points anywhere on the eastern seaboard that Atlantic salmon can get back to their historic habitat.
We're sitting on the Henderson Brook. We're here because we're working on an aquatic barrier removal and stream restoration project to open up a length of the Henderson Brook that is currently inaccessible to fish. The real problem with the culvert on the Henderson Brook is that it's what we call a perched culvert, and that means that the outflow end of the culvert is sitting pretty far above the stream bed. And because of that, the fish are not able, because they're young, small fish, they're not able to make that jump up into the culvert. Right now, Atlantic salmon are not able to access any of the brook above the culvert, and that additional 3.7 miles could support up to 1,000 juvenile Atlantic salmon. And so we really want to be able to open that up and hopefully help restore that species.
When we talk about doing these fish restoration projects, it's relatively simple because the upstream habitat is there and it's complete and functioning. The real problem literally is the culvert. And so we can go in and pull that culvert and put in an open bottom bridge and match in the stream bottom with the stream bottom up and downstream and pull the block nets, and fish will travel that day. I mean, there's no recovery period. They're drawn to cold, fast moving water. And so, I mean, the return is instantaneous. So when you think about the scale of environmental problems that we're facing today, why wouldn't we do this?
The Appalachian Trail experience is so many different things to so many different people. And for me, it's really about being in nature. It's about seeing, experiencing, hearing, and having those opportunities. And not only do we want to protect the experience of folks walking on the Appalachian Trail itself, but all of the land that surrounds the trail makes up part of that experience. So having healthy streams and healthy forests is really an important piece of what the Appalachian Trail Conservancy is focusing on. We are working hard to steward the resources that are in that landscape that we're responsible for caring for.
It's projects like this and getting involved in this effort that really do give me hope. Otherwise, I wouldn't be in conservation, you know, if I didn't have some hope. I think for me, it would be hard to live without the knowledge that there are places still left where nature prevails. And that's what I love about the Maine woods. Here you're a part of nature, you're not just a spectator, and you really can sort of take a backseat to the whole experience and let nature be on the center stage.
People have been able to come out here to Gulf Haggis and the Appalachian Trail and physically see the habitat, so it means more to them. People walk across here, this Hermitage Crossing on the Appalachian Trail, and they'll say, oh, Atlantic salmon were right at my feet. So it means more because they've been here and they've almost touched them.
That's really one of the most amazing things about this fisheries restoration work is it's using these skill sets like forestry, like road construction, like research, and like recreation to help restore these natural systems to functionality. And in so doing, you end up restoring both communities, both the local people, the local population, and their economic vitality, and spiritual connectedness to the place, but also the ecological resilience of these forests. As the world has gotten smaller, as people travel farther and farther and farther to be in places like this, this just isn't our forest anymore. This is suddenly everybody's backyard. So it matters, and it should matter to everyone, that these places are interconnected, that they function, and that they carry the constellation of ecological values forward into the future that we know they can. What gives me hope about these places is knowing that they're going to be here, and that somebody else gets the chance, the same way I was afforded, to think in an unfettered way about what the possibilities are. Because I think that ability for people to see themselves in these landscapes and see a future here, that's priceless.